गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, दिस इज ज्वेरिया तलत, पीजीटी मैथ्स फ्रॉम मॉडल स्कूल मुटराजपल्ली गजवेल. टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक प्रोबेबिलिटी. इन आवर डेली लाइफ वी कम अक्रॉस मेनी सिचुएशंस एंड स्टेटमेंट्स. लेट अस गो थ्रू फ्यू स्टेटमेंट्स such as it will probably rain today, I doubt that he will pass the test, most probably Pooja will stand first in annual examinations, chances are high that the prices of diesel will go up. In the above sentences, the words probably, doubt, most probably, chances are involving an element of uncertainty, which is lack of surety. This lack of surety or probability can be measured numerically by means of probability in many cases. Before that, let us go through few terms which will help us understand the topic, that is probability. The first one is certain. Certain is something that must occur. Any situation which is supposed to happen and it will definitely happen, such are considered as certain. For example, Christmas will be celebrated on 25th of December. This is something which cannot be changed. It is something, the situation will definitely happen. The next word is more likely. Something that would occur with great chance. It means that there are more chances for such a situation to happen. For example, the marks secured in SSC by a candidate is more likely to be used for many competitive exams. So it means there are more chances that a student's marks secured by her will be used in competitive exams. Next one is equally likely. Something that have the same chance of occurring means the possibility for it to happen or not to happen is equal. For example, after purchasing a cloth, it is equally likely to be stitched as a top or a bottom. Means there are equal chance that a cloth can be stitched as a top or a bottom. Next is less likely. Something that would occur with less chance. There is a very less chance for this situation to occur. For example, it is the wealth of a mad person is less likely to be used for a good purpose by him. When he is mad, definitely there are less chances that he will use the wealth in a good purpose. Impossible. Something that cannot happen. As we all know, it is impossible to have 32 days in a month. Okay, so let us discuss a new term, that is random experiment. What is random experiment? Experiments in which we know the possible outcomes before conducting the experiment, but we cannot predict the exact outcome that occurs at a particular time in advance. For example, I am tossing a coin. A coin is having two sides. One is head and the other one is tail. when before I toss a coin, I know the outcome could be either a head or a tail. So the result, the outcomes are known to me, but the exact outcome which comes if a coin is tossed is not known. So that is considered as a random experiment. Let us see in the case of dice. Dice is also having six sides. So before you roll a dice, there are six sides, there is a possibility that any of the side can be shown, and the result is the possibility for any of the side is equal. So we know what are the outcomes, but we can't say what exactly will come as our result. Such experiment is called as a random experiment. So it is also called as a trial. Now let us go through an example of a dice again. What are the possible outcomes of a dice? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. That is having a 6 sides. So altogether they are called as a sample space. So out of the 6 sides, if I prefer an even prime number to be my outcome, then the only possibility will be 2. That is only one side where my outcome can be an even prime number. Similarly, if I prefer even numbers as my outcome, then the only possibilities are 2, 4 and 6. That is, there are only 3 possibilities, so only 3 outcomes. Out of total 6 outcomes of a dice, the sides which are showing an even numbers are only 2, 4 and 6. This specific outcome, like even numbers or even prime, they are called as event, or the collection of specific outcome will be called as an event. So let us see the formula related to probability. So what is probability? It is the formula for probability of an event A. Event A is the specific outcome which we are preferring. So P of A, that is probability for an event A to happen, can be measured using this formula, which is number of favorable outcomes for an event A by the number of total possible outcomes. So what are favorable? The one which we are considering. As previously we said, even number, that is something which we are favoring. The next is even numbers, that is something which we are preferring. So they are considered as favorable outcomes. Coming to the denominator, number of total possible outcomes. So in case of dice, the total possible outcomes are 6. So let us go through an example now. If two identical coins are tossed simultaneously, what are the different cases we can see? As there are two coins, there is a possibility that both the coins show a head. The next possibility is the first coin is showing a head and the second one as a tail. Third case, first coin outcome is tail and second coin outcome is head. In the last case, where both the coins have shown or having the outcome as tail. So these are the 4 possible outcomes when two coins are tossed. That is our first bit. Coming to second bit, probability of getting two heads. So the condition here is two heads. So the event is where we are getting two heads, which is the only the first case. So the possibility of getting two heads is only the first case, which is one, and the number of total possible outcomes as our first bit, which is four. So the probability of getting two heads is 1/4. Coming to C bit, probability of getting at least one head. Here it is mentioned as at least. It can be one or more than one. So in this case, our first case, that is both the coins are having the outcome as head, will be considered, as well as second and third cases where head is shown once will also be considered. So first three are all the favorable conditions. So our numerator is 3. And coming to denominator, which is number of total possible outcomes as mentioned in the first bit, that is A bit, is 4. So the probability of getting at least one head is 3/4. Coming to D bit, probability of getting no heads. So whether it is one or two, now no head should be considered. So how many such possibilities are there? So the only possibility is the last case, where both the coins are showing the outcome as tail. So there is only one such case. So favorable condition, number of favorable outcomes for the event A, our event is getting no head, which is the last case, so it is 1. And number of total possible outcomes, which is 4, so it is 1/4. So probability of getting no heads is 1/4. Coming to E bit, probability of getting only one head. So one head, it is either it is the second and third case. First case will not be considered because the condition is only one head. So first is not considered. Last case is also not considered because both of them have showed a tail. So the favorable conditions are only the second and third case. So the number of outcomes which will show only one head is only second and third. So it is favorable outcomes are 2. Number of favorable outcomes for the event A is only one head, which is second and third, and the possible outcomes are 4. So 2/4, which is equal to 1/2. Okay, so the probability of a sure or a certain event is always 1. When we are sure that a certain thing is going to happen, then its probability will be 1. Probability of impossible event is 0. And the probability of an event will always lie between 0 and 1. Its uses in our real life, like how probability is used in our life, at least it will be used by meteorological department to predict the weather, whether rain is going to occur a certain part of the state in such cases, or as well as in exit poll to be taken before, after an election, to survey, and in any case to predict. This probability will be helpful. Let us go through what we have learned today. We have learned relating probability with daily life, daily situations, and you'll be able to know the terms less likely, more likely, equally likely, certain, and impossible events. Also, I have understood the formula related to probability. Hope you understood the topic well. Thank you.